Today, we'll give you a short introduction of our newest products released in October 2021. At RF Elements, we address the problem of RF noise by changing the paradigm of fixed wireless industry. We're setting new industry standard for RF performance, noise rejection, and system scalability. The number one challenge the WISPs are facing, even today, is that of RF noise in the unlicensed spectra. WISPs commonly see spectral graphs with high to very high noise levels that prevent the wireless networks from optimal functioning and sometimes even to the point of giving up on the unlicensed spectrum and the business altogether. The main issue here are the antenna side lobes, which are almost never mentioned when talking about antennas. People do talk about gain, beamwidth, bandwidth, maybe front-to-back ratio, but not about the side lobes, which are the root cause of the problems with noise in unlicensed WISP networks. Here you see examples of how the noise is generated. Besides the main direction, these antennas radiate energy in every other direction as well. This weaker radiation is the cause of the side lobes that create unwanted coverage. So these antennas transmit and receive the noise from its surroundings. And this is how the noise-rejecting antennas work. All the energy they radiate and receive is contained in the direction of the main lobe. And everywhere else, there's nothing. So the horn antennas do not receive or create noise, effectively dealing with interference at its root. While with the traditional sector antenna, the network performance is at the mercy of the surrounding noise sources because its side lobes receive and transmit the interference, switching to horns provides the high throughput and stability because they do not receive the noise at all. In our reference radio design, we removed the pigtails and integrated the transition from the radio to the antenna directly into the radio circuit board through the TwistPort mail connector. This way, the radio can be attached to any TwistPort antenna while introducing practically zero loss. Therefore, TwistPort is truly a revolutionary interface, introducing a whole new ecosystem built on the advantages of the waveguide and excellent mechanical design, enabling easy connection with virtually zero loss RF performance. Before we came with symmetrical horns, WISPs had choice between two or three antenna beamwidths with unstable coverage suffering from high background noise level. Now the gain and beamwidth options and easy collocation of horns enable unprecedented scalability. WISPs now have 11 different tools with stable coverage enabling highly granular and precise style of planning. There's virtually no limit to network scalability. This is the epitome of our core message, sustainable and fast wireless. By bringing the horns to the WISP market, we opened the possibilities previously unthinkable, changing the paradigm of wireless industry altogether. Shield kits like these were pretty much the only option WISPs had before the RF element horns came to the market to try to improve the noise issues the traditional sector and directional antennas bring, and unfortunately with not much success, since the shields and shrouds do not really do much with the side lobes as such. With horns, the lack of side lobes sets you free in terms of the network coverage planning and execution as well. There is absolutely no limit in terms of the mixing and matching different beamwidths and gains, depending on the sector density, and installations like these are super easy to do. Bringing your network to a whole new level of performance is a real option with horn technology. The maximum throughput you can run on one tower is no longer a limit of the gear you're using, but it is your choice, since the links with horns do not interfere with each other, so they can leverage the most from the RF radios you use. Raising awareness and educating the industry is a huge part of our activities. Having brought the right solution to the issue of noise, we had to introduce a whole new set of vocabulary and knowledge as well to improve the understanding of how it works to bring about the adoption of the horn technology. And it was completely new and unknown, but we choose to do the right thing for the industry. And we do continue with user education to this day, in fact. It is one of our many first in the WISP industry kind of things that we at our developments can put on display. Now, our idea is that only educated customer can make qualified decision. And we're also very open about myth busting because there are many myths and misconceptions that create big problems to many network operators. At the same time, we do stay close to our customers. We love it, and it really allows us to understand them well and helps us to keep bringing the solutions that they really need. We listen carefully and act on the customer's feedback. It is important in order to keep in touch with our customer base. Let's now have a look at our recent product updates. The three Product of the Year awards in a row, which we thank our customers for voting us into those, give a clear message to us that the asymmetrical horns are the right product for WISP networks delivering top-notch performance, and we keep improvements coming. We are upgrading the mounting mechanism of all the asymmetrical horns. The latest updates were done on the 60-degree asymmetrical horn with the 17 dBi gain and the 90-degree asymmetrical horn with 16 dBi gain. And the same goes for the carrier class version of these antennas. They have identical RF performance, but instead of the TwistPort connector, they offer two and female connectors for those who might prefer this interface. The upgraded mounting solution is composed of a whole new UBR bracket and an extruded aluminium ring around the perimeter of the antenna body to improve the structural strength of the antenna attachment to the tower, wind resistance of the antenna installation, and also making the beam switch feature a lot easier to perform, which is the feature of the 30-degree asymmetrical horn. Our completely new UBR bracket is made of massive aluminium profiles with bigger contact surface with the pole. Now, combined with the minimum size of the bolts being M8, the strength of the attachment of our antennas to the tower is greatly improved. And the azimuth and elevation measures are now engraved in the bracket body. And the main bracket bolts have black-colored anti-seize surface coating that prevents their seizing and eventually extending the lifetime of the whole bracket as such. Let's now have a look at our completely new products. StarterHorn A45 is the newest addition to the Starter antenna group, which are the antennas suitable for operators that are starting out with RF elements technology, or those who are not ready to commit to TwistPort ecosystem for whatever reason. StarterHorn A45 has 17 dBi gain, asymmetrical radiation pattern, and an attractive pricing. The radiation pattern of the StarterHorn A45 is asymmetrical. It has 45 degrees in the azimuth plane and 30 degrees in the elevation plane. So the asymmetrical pattern increases the gain of the antenna and makes it more useful in terrains that are not extremely mountainous and have middle customer density. Both StarterHorn A45 and StarterHorn 30 are access point antennas for dense collocation scenarios. Their gain is similar, but the azimuth beam width is 45 degrees for the A45 and 30 degrees for the STH30. Their beam efficiency is very high for great noise rejection capability, and the main difference is that a StarterHorn A45 is suitable for middle density access point applications, while the StarterHorn 30 is suitable for high density coverage due to the narrower radiation pattern. We offer a 5 GHz array sector antenna already, and now we are extending the offer to the array sectors for the 3 GHz and 2 GHz frequency bands, since noise is an issue also there. So let's have a look at our upcoming array sectors. In 2 GHz, we're adding two antennas, the AS214 and AS217, with 14 and 17 dBi gain, covering the 100 MHz of spectrum starting at 2.4 GHz. They have horizontal vertical polarization and RP-SMA radio interface. In 3 GHz band, we now offer one horizontal vertical polarized array sector with RP-SMA interface and two other ones with similar gain but different beam widths for more coverage planning options. The last two antennas also have dual slant polarization and N female connectors that are standard in these frequency bands. All our array sectors shown have backshield integrated in their body. It is a frequency selective surface with varying ridges and cutouts that effectively suppresses the azimuth side lobes, greatly improving the collocation and noise rejection of the array sector antennas. Our array sector antennas have radiation pattern that's identical for both polarizations, and that's regardless if it's the horizontal vertical one or the dual slant polarized antennas. Now, this is important for a reliable coverage when you switch between the radio channels, and especially for customers that are close to the edges of the sector. While on the other hand, the mainstream sector antennas have the two radiation patterns different, which makes obvious issues when you're switching between the radio channels. The bracket of our array sectors received a major upgrade as well. The robust aluminum profiles hold the antenna firmly attached to the pole, and the installation is also greatly improved and simplified, since only four bolts are needed to attach it to the tower, and these bolts also have the black-colored anti-seize surface coating that improves the lifetime of the bracket. The two 2 GHz array sectors are available already now, and differ mainly in the gain options available. So one has 14 and the other 17 dBi gain, with pricing of $182 and $210. The 2 GHz array sector antennas have our standard RP-SMA interface that lets you connect most common 2 GHz radios used in WISP industry. Now, the interface is also protected by a plastic hood that slides on top of it. Starting from the second quarter of 2022, we will include a mount for any cambium EPMP radio in the package of the array sector antennas, and it will be part of the 2 GHz and the 5 GHz array sector antennas, yeah? So not the 3 GHz. The new 3 GHz array sector antennas have 17 and 18 dBi gain, with beamwidths of 90 and 65 degrees. And they both have dual slant polarization and female connector radio interface, and will be available in the first quarter of 2022. Both of the 3 GHz array sectors with the dual slant polarization feature innovative covers for the connector interface protection. The integrated sliding cover with a silicone plug ensures IP55 proofing, and the cable tie bracket makes sure that the cables will not move. And here you see how it works. The cables are in a neutral position with no strain on them, and the combination of the sliding cover and the silicone plug ensure impeccable weather resistance. The horizontal and vertically polarized 3 GHz array sector antenna has 90 degrees beamwidth, standard RP-SMA interface, and $280 MSRP, and it is available already with our distributors. To sum it up, we are adding two array sectors in the 2 GHz band with two gain options for better coverage planning, One 3 GHz array sector with RPSMA interface and horizontal vertical polarization options, and two 3 GHz array sectors with dual slant polarization and innovative and female connectorized interface with IP55 weatherproofing. In the second quarter of 2022, we'll release a TwistPort adapter that works with the two Mimosa radios with waveguide output, the C5x radio and the B5x. So both of these radios can be connected to our antennas with one and the same adapter, and that's TPA AMU. And finally, we have a few practical updates you should know about. The main stainless steel bolts attaching our antennas to the tower now have black-colored surface coating that decreases the friction coefficient between the thread and the bolt, which effectively protects the whole bracket from seizing and extending its lifetime in the end. Some of our customers' regions, like Mexico, Australia, or New Zealand, have a climate that might cause our bracket parts oxidize prematurely, examples of which you can see here. The challenging environments with high humidity, salinity, or presence of other chemicals in the air may cause heavy oxidation on the diecast part of the horn bracket. Now, despite the number of affected products is less than 0.5% out of those which are deployed, we will address this issue in the next generation of symmetrical horns. Now, before that happens, though, you can get your affected part of the bracket replaced already now. Simply place an RMA with your local distributor, and they will get you the bracket arm with special surface coating that can resist the challenging environments. We also recommend getting this arm for the symmetrical horn installs that you know will be deployed in environmentally challenging areas before you even go there in the first place. Again, contact your local distributors to get more information on where to get these brackets. On our webpage, you can download simplified 3D models of our antennas to help you with the precise planning of your deployments on your site. It is much easier than modeling the antennas yourself. Another item in our download section that might interest you are the radiation patterns of our antennas for the Google Planner, if you use this tool. Again, for simpler and easier planning of your deployments. To our data sheets, we already added the wind load data for all our antennas for two views, so the front and the side. So if your WISP is located in an area with heavy winds, you'll definitely appreciate this information when planning your next deployments. From now on, we can no longer guarantee you that we'll have replacement parts to send to you for all the first generation of symmetrical horns and the StationBox XLCC. However, you can always find their datasheets and other information on our webpage in the discontinued product section. I'd also like to invite you to join our user forum, the RFE Lab, where we have a lot of useful information about our products, where our customers asked a lot of questions, you might have as well, or you can ask your own questions if you won't find the answers you're looking for. And we also have a user group on Facebook, the RF Elements English, which serves pretty much the same purpose. But if Facebook is your preferred platform, then of course, feel free to contact us also there. We recently started doing a licensed podcast where Tassos and Caleb talk about plenty of interesting WISP topics with weekly new episodes, including interviews with guests from the industry. And finally, I will only mention that we use the third-party trademarks only to reference the compatibility with our products. Thank you for your attention and have a good day.